My name is Socks Whitmore. My pronouns are they, them, theirs, and welcome to the concert reading of Back to One, A Coming of Self musical. This show was originally my graduation recital project back in 2020. It was scheduled for April 18th of 2020, and we all know how that went. Hop, skip, and a jump later, here we are, and it is back on stage for the first time in 3 years. I am so excited to share this piece with you. I'll share a brief content advisory that we include intense depictions of misgenderment and gender dysphoria in this show, so just keeping that in mind for your safety. Bring tissues, basically. But hope you enjoy. This is Back to One.
Just ride.
Don't be late to come.
Just give it a few days and some coffee.
A lot of coffee.
Well, I hope you know I'm happy to look over pages for you if it helps. And speaking of pages, I just thought I'd bring over a draft of the pilot Miranda has been working on. Everything is still fluid at this point, of course. So don't make too many assumptions, but I figured if you just want to take a peek, see if it whets your appetite.
10 years later, grows up to be a nurse. Three kids, single mom.
So, what do you think?
Nothing is more important to me than being a mother. In what universe would you, or any person, say that?
Okay, sure. The wording's a little clunky, but it'll get polished in the next draft. The point is, we want fans to see from the get-go how Lucy's motherhood experience traces back to the special relationship that she had with her own mother in the first episode.
Actually, I can tell you're really happy about this reboot, but why are you telling me this?
Because I want you to see how much every little thing matters to people. To this team, to your fans, to me, to you. I want you to meet with Miranda and talk about coming back.
Not Miranda, won't speak to you. Well, we're doing it. Every little thing is not for real.
Maybe not these exact 24 pages, but hey, with your inside knowledge of Lucy, think about all the ideas that you could bring to the table, huh? Do you remember episode 32? Yeah, when you were 10, you still had a DVD player, right?
I mean, yes, but I really
don't. Okay, great. That. Just let me show you what I'm talking about. I love this one.
Come on, Lucy. It's bring your kid to work today.
What other kid am I going to bring to work? Macaulay Culkin?
I don't want to go to the office. It's full of boring people.
Well, I'm not boring, am I?
Mean.
Well, you know what? You always tell me to find the fun in everything, so I challenge you to find the fun in my office.
Can I bring Barbie to work?
Oh, certainly. But Barbie's going to have to apply for an interview. She's interested in musicians.
Well, that's silly. Barbie's already been a secretary, and a scientist, and an astronaut, and an architect, and a rock star. She's the most qualified person for the job.
All of those things? Sounds like Barbie has some commitment issues. But I bet she likes being a secretary, right?
I don't know. I haven't asked. Barbie, did you like being a secretary?
Well, I guess I did, Lucy. In fact, I think you'd make a great secretary. Do you want to be a secretary just like your mom?
Is it fun?
With you, everything is fun. Lucy, you're going to grow up to become something special. You know that?
Yeah. show you what it looks like on camera. The guys were showing me some of the new gear we got for season 2. And you
Miss Miranda says I need to have more sex.
What, sex, huh? Well, I'm pretty sure you've got plenty in you. It's just taking a while to wake up today.
I guess so.
Hey, chin up, girlie.
You got this. You want to go out for ice cream after we shoot? Sounds like a plan. Now, just remember, when you're done, you gotta be all okay. Alrighty, let's take it from my computer. Pictures.
Actually, I was wondering if this time I could do a scene a little different.
Rewritten as a hippie drift through the bright light. You say so, but I don't see them in anything else. But
that Lizzy knows the story I need to
know. What?
You know what? I'm gonna
grab some coffee.
Right now?
Yeah, I've got a lot of writing to do.
Shit. So I realized that I didn't really ask.
ask you what you want to do. Oh, thank you, Lizzy. I have so many more ideas. I'm crazy. On the way back, I started thinking about that, headlight episode. Imagine Lucy and her kids in Japan.
And then they get into a conversation with
an
so deep into this.
I wanted us to take another look at that script.
Oh, what script?
Every little thing, silly. Miranda is so excited to talk with you about it.
Oh, Beth. Well,
no, I can change it in 2 years.
I guess you can hurt to sit and copy with her or something.
I am so glad you feel that way. This is going to work out perfectly.
What do you mean?
Mentioned you had some notes on the pilot, and since I was already in the area, I thought I might as well come over and read them straight from you. You get a chance to look at the legal stuff?
Legal?
Contracts, clauses, conditions, etc. I know you haven't done much since the parting of ways we had all those years ago, so I can't imagine pay is something you're too picky about. But I do have the expectation of the role to be clear.
What role exactly?
Lucy Sweet, of course. Actually told me how excited you were to bring Lucy back. It was a thrilling opportunity for an actor to reprise a role in such a promising revival.
I'm sure. How kind of action and such a reward for me.
Listen, the Every Little Thing reboot is going to bring your career back to life, kiddo! You can tell Lucy's story and be a star again.
Well, let's not count our ratings before they crash, but I have a gut feeling that this reboot is going to kill with the nostalgia. I'll admit it, Lizzy, I have some reservations about offering the role. But Ashley convinced me that it would be vital to capturing the evolution of Lucy's voice.
Yeah, well, about that.
Yeah, as a little girl, you were always trying to rewrite the script on me. Not as hard as the time, but no, look at you. I practically inspired you to become a writer. Ashley tells me you write under a pen name these days.
Oh, well, that's not exactly what I did.
For the last time, you have to wear a dress.
And for the last time, the character would rather wear this.
That's not how it works. We can't shoot a scene at the spring formal with you in sweatpants. Look, Lizzy, you wear the clothes for a few hours, shoot everything quick and easy, and then you look at my screen. How's that?
I'm 13 years old. You can't buy a new bear anymore.
Okay, well, let me put it this way. Your sister signed a contract with me, so until that piece of paper expires, you do what I say.
That's not fair.
That's showbiz.
This was supposed to be my new home.
It still can be, Lizzy, but you have to play the part.
It's not what I thought it was.
Scheduling therapy sessions is the PA's job. Wear a dress and be the good girl you need to be.
Lucy doesn't want to be a good girl!
What's going on?
The star isn't cooperating. Oh,
come on, girlie. The sooner you do the scene, the sooner we can go out for ice cream.
I don't want ice cream, and I don't want to wear the dress!
You have to.
Lucy has fallen to bloom. Lucy will wear the high temperance. Sparks of religion.
This, but I still see her in the best parts, the charm and the humor and the imagination. And also, I see
see how those things were part of Jacob all along. How Jake was growing up right in front of me, and I didn't see it.
No, no one could. I mean, all they could see was Lucy's feet. It's funny how spending 5 to 4 years as a fictionalized personality for public consumption is not actually that beneficial to you.
I hear that.
But who knows?
Maybe someday a kid like Lucy Sweet will change his name on TV and show the world what it needs to be for boys like him.
They really want to watch a story like that.
Well, I'm sure that there's some 9-year-old out there who could really use that story right now. Or some 34-year-old older sister. And you could write it.
What?
Jake, I read the screenplay.
No.
Not the one with Lucy as a pilot, but the little girl with her sister at the audition. I know you threw it out before you finished it, but what if, instead of telling it the way that it happened to us, you told the story that you wanted it to be? Think about
a little boy who is very, very loved for who he is. That's beautiful. I think it's the time. Really, it's hurt.
Your pay, which you can admission for queer kids and their families. So,
yeah.